Let's understand the inner class, how we can create inner class here. It's a very good important topic of Java. Consider I have a class here, say class. I just give a author, okay. Inside that I say here class inner. Inside this I say class nested class. Okay, here I say inner class, here I say outer class, okay, and say here application. I will using here. Saving the file. Now what do you know here? If I go for compilation of this program Java C and I say app.java, there's no error, right? Now this is called top level class. What is that? Top level class. Okay, this is called top level class. Top level class, I cannot write private here. Check it out. See, it is giving error. Modify private not allowed here, right? I cannot write protected. Understood. So I can write only public and default, means without access file. But if we are writing public here, look it now, then your file name should match with outer class. See, if you are writing public, should be declared in the file name outer class.java. So your file name should not be app.java, it should be outer class.java. So I am not having this public, suppose. Okay. Now this is called inner class. Why? Right now both are inner class, or I can say both are nested class, right? Class inside the class, so nested class. But once I make this guy static, now it is a nested class. Nested class, right? But this is the inner class, this is nested class. Okay. Now, if I need to create object, nested class, see, all class can be nested class, right? All nested class cannot be inner class. All inner class can be nested class, all nested class can be nested class. Well, but all nested class cannot be inner class or nested class. Could be inner class, could be nested class. So if it is a static nested class, we can say nested class exactly. If it is a non-static nested class, then we say it is an inner class. So this is a real inner class, right? If this guy is having method, if this guy is having method, I want to call the method here, then how to call? I need to create object of this guy, right? I need to create object of this guy. So if I do here, outer class dot inner class x equal to new outer class dot inner class. Is it the right syntax? Check it out. It is giving error. An enclosing instance that contains outer class inner class is required. But let us comment this now. Can I do this one? Outer class dot nested class x1 equal to new outer class dot nested class, right? Can I do this one? Yes. See, there's no error. Since it is static, so I can call directly from this class, right? So outer class dot nested class x1 equal to new. But how I can call this? I need the object. It is not a static, right? I need to create object of this guy first. So here, see the syntax. Now there's a little different syntax here. Outer class k equal to new outer class, right? And then you have to do what? Outer class dot inner class x equal to k dot new. See, k dot new inner class. You have to write this syntax. So first create object of outer class and then associate this object to the inner class like this, k dot new. Then you will get the object of this inner class. Right? Check it out. It's compiled now, right? So you have to perform this two line here for obtaining the object of inner class. But for nested class, it is direct. You can do like this. Understood? Now I'm going to make one more example. Runnable class is there. Sorry, runtime class. We can use that runtime class here. Okay, so in runtime class, what we can do? Let us say you want to run some external application. It is not related to inner class. There are some other class also like, okay, let me explain this first. Suppose here you have one method, say void m, this method is there, okay. Inside this, if you write some class name, then we can say this is local class, okay. What? Local class. Yeah. So inside this, if I say class, I'll just say here LOC. Now this class, I cannot access outside. It can be used inside the method only. Here you can say LOC, L equal to new LOC like that, right? Here only you can do. You cannot create object of this class outside. Check it out. So you're getting that, right? No errors are coming, isn't it? Okay. So this is what kind of class? Local class. So you understood one top level inner class and then nested class, right? And local class. So these are the four, right? One more, there's an anonymous class which we declared in between the method, right? And another is the nested class. So all both are the nested class here, but in nested we are having inner and nested class, okay? Okay, so understood the nested class concept. Even if you have some interface, say interface, XY, inside that, again you can say interface, AV. So what is this? It is a nested interface, right? It is a nested interface here. The benefit of or usefulness of this stuff is very almost zero. But in Java you will find one interface that is a map interface. It is having one nested interface that is an entry. That is one example of nested interface in Java API. Okay. So make it new here. I just make new application here, say RDemo. Suppose if you want to run the Java program and during education, some other of the other application will get executed. Say Notepad will start, my calculator will start. It's very simple. In the lang package, I have a class runtime r equal to runtime.getRuntime. Get runtime. So we are obtaining the runtime object here. We cannot create object of runtime because there is no public constructor in the runtime class here. And then I can say there's a one process you have to take, process p equal to null. You can take p1 equal to null. And then I say runtime, p1 equal to r dot execute. What execute? I say here notepad dot exe. So give the file name here. Remove this line now. And we can save this file. Look it now. If I say Java C RDemo dot Java, it is giving error here, unreported exception. Okay, just write here throws IO exception. Okay, or you can also say exception here, but you need to just say exception. It can handle it. Otherwise, you have to import the package, IO package. Okay, run the code now. Java R demo. Java R demo. What you have noticed? Once I'm running the program, I'm getting Notepad opened, right? Close it. I say here calc.exe means open the calculator. See, calculator has been opened, right? So you need to pass some exe file here. If I want to open Word, just say bin Word. So it is not getting the path of bin Word. You can give the full path of MS Word wherever it is installed. Okay. You just say cmd.exe. It will open new command prompt. It's I think because of already it is opened, so it is not opening here, right? Well, so you understood the runtime class now. I explained the math class here. There's a math class. It is important class. Lot of mathematical function in the math class we have. So consider, go to the file and say new Java. Here I just say math demo. Okay, inside this I can use here int x equal to 5 comma y equal to 10, something like this, and I say double z equal to 0, or say 0.0 here, right? Now I can call here, or I just say here double d equal to math dot. So there's a math class, power of x comma 2 means x square, plus math dot power y comma 2 y square. Okay, and now z equal to sqrt, so math dot sqrt square root of d. So find the square root of d and store in z. And I can display message the right angle triangle, I mean hypotenuse. Right, how much plus z, save it. So class is math demo dot java, right? Sorry, save now. Go to the code here and say java c math demo dot java, right? So it is saying it is not available. Oh, I need to say here java c here, right? It has been compiled now. I say java math demo. You're getting the hypotenuse, it is 11, right? So if it is a 3, if it is a 4, how much? Let us check it out. So 5 is answer, right? So this is what power, square root, lot of mathematical functions we are having. Once I say java c java.lang.math. I have to say java p here, and you can see the java docs also, right? So see, lot of functions, cos, sine, tan, max, mean, ron, all this function you can use. But have a notice, all the functions are static, all are static, right? All are static. So how you can call directly math dot, and it is a final class, so you cannot inherit it. Okay, now there's a new feature as added in JDK 1.5 that import java dot import a static. See, java dot lang dot math dot star, you have to import like this. Once you import this math class, you in this code you need not to import it. But if you don't want to write this math also, say here I will just remove this math. Okay, so it's look like very common or methods of this class, right? But exactly this method is available here only. So both are the same. Now you can compile the code here. It's compiling and getting output, right? Okay, that's all about inner class and runtime and math class.